Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. I'm doing laundry, so you'll hear that chug 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 noise in the background. Here in South Dakota, we've had at least one earthquake. I think there's a couple more that USGS is not reporting. At about 7:51 and 40 seconds universal time, you'll see this earthquake right here. Sharp popping of the rock. But I was shocked at the heat and the magma that came up during this earthquake. The earthquake station that I downloaded the data from is right here by the Black Hills. Over here we have Bear Butte. This is a area of an ancient volcano. Supposedly about 50,000 years ago, magma came up, and they don't know if it erupted because it's so greatly deteriorated. It's a sacred site for the Native Americans. That volcano is supposed to be a laccolith type volcano. It is a body of intrusive rock with a dome-shaped upper surface and a level base fed by a conduit, kind of like Yellowstone, from below. A laccolith forms when magma, molten rock, rises through the Earth's crust, begins to spread out horizontally, and that's been what's been going on there at Yellowstone also. Pry apart the host rock strain. The pressure of the magma is high enough that the overlying strata are forced upward, giving the Lakota its dome-like form. Over time, erosion can expose the solidified laccolith, which is typically more resistant to weathering than the host rock. The exposed laccolith then forms a hill or a mountain. Henry Mountain in Utah are examples of mountain range composed of exposed laccolith. Here's an image of the conduit and the rise of what is now called Bear Butte. The area around the Black Hills was created by volcanic activity. The area has lots of caves, either formed by erosion or maybe they were lava tubes. Supposedly the Black Hills has been eroding about 1 inch every 10,000 years. I do know that there is a lot of sediment in this area, so earthquakes would travel, and anything large would, you know, probably cause damage. It didn't really show up on the monitor that I downloaded from Sioux Falls. So we'll go to that location, and let me show you where Sioux Falls is at. Yeah, South Dakota really doesn't have that many large cities. Sioux Falls, Rapid, and Aberdeen are the three largest cities here. So yeah, that monitor there didn't really pick up this earthquake, but what I noticed was it did show up on the earthquake.usgs.gov website. And let's bring this up. I'm going to show you. Yeah, this is it for the Black Hills, and we got a little one there. Here where I live, about 4 hours from the Black Hills, and once in a while I feel a little rumble. Not really a rumble, I'll just feel like a small vibration. So this earthquake, supposedly, if I'm calculating the time right, was at 11:51 p.m. local time. That's Central Daylight Time. That would have been June 5th, almost. A couple minutes later, it would have been today, June 6, 2022. They should have reported it. They do have it marked in red, means the computer picked it up. Here is images, stream view. Looks like there's another small quake right there more recently. This here is that earthquake. Now, I come up with a magnitude 1.87, and you will see down here, for the Sioux Falls monitor, it also picked it up there, barely. So going back to, let's see the earthquake signature again. And I'll bring it down so you can see if you're watching this on a larger computer or your TV. You can see it's a magnitude 1.87. Now at 20:39, it picked up another earthquake. It could have been one worldwide. I'm not sure. I'm a little suspicious about it. But this one too brought up magma. A lot of gases. Let me bring it over and you can see all the... Oops, I went off the line. Let's see, right there. Okay, a lot of gases. It really rocked and rolled. It could have been a large earthquake somewhere else in the world. And there's its earthquake signature. It's got a very long P wave on it. Let's extract that. Yeah, see, that is volcanic activity, which is really interesting. So this earthquake did cause, the Black Hills magma chamber to rattle. You know, here we got the threat of Yellowstone, and now to think it might have the threat of volcanoes erupting because of the weakening Earth's magnetic field erupting here in South Dakota. Now, this one would have been also, I believe, on the 5th. Yeah, the 5th. Right there. 6.5. And it came in here at... first started at 20:39. Now, I really shortened up the seismic signature, so I'm sure I'm off, but it comes in as a magnitude 3.59. I am sure if that is the real case, people there in Rapid City would have been reporting this earthquake. But I really shortened it up. Yeah, and I probably shouldn't have. I know Tonga was having earthquakes, but the time, you know, giving travel time doesn't make sense. You know, they got one in Hawaii, but that would not pick it up. Western Texas was way before. Yeah, I don't see anything for that time for that earthquake to register here in South Dakota. And it's not going to show on here because it only goes back to... 1800 hours. There is a little blip right there. Oh, there is a blip there. All right, at 2000 hours. Okay. But it's got a long P wave and having a little blip. Wherever it happened, USGS is not reporting it. See, and it only shows up here on the Black Hills monitor. And it doesn't show up. Not really, for the one for Sioux Falls. So this one's really a mystery. So anyways, that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments, or if you did feel something on Sunday, put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you.